All right, so now we're going to learn about Boolean operators. Boolean operators are something that you use when you've got two different concepts and you want to show that they belong together. One example is Oreos and milk. Oreos and milk always belong together. Another example of two things that I always think of together, you know, just like from the movie, peas and carrots. Peas and carrots always belong together. Thank you, Forrest Gump. Another thing that in my world, at least, always belongs together is bar of chocolate and peanut butter, because they just love each other. So when you're doing your research, how do you show that two things belong together, like remote sensing or spatial analysis? You can even sometimes show that three things belong together, like geographic and information and systems. It doesn't have to be just two. So how do you actually do that when you're searching for something like remote sensing? Well, what you do is you use the Boolean operator AND. That tells the computer that these two things belong together, that they only make sense to you together. So what actually happens in the computer is that it searches for the word remote, and it pulls up all the journal articles that have the word remote in it. It also does a search for the word sensing, and it pulls up all journal articles that have the word sensing in them. But it filters it out and only shows you the journal articles that have remote and sensing in it, both of them, that little slice right in the middle. So what do you do if you're looking for two terms? Like you're looking for remote sensing, but you're also looking for spatial analysis. You want information about either of those topics. Well, you use the Boolean operator OR. It's kind of like when you go to a restaurant and the waitress walks up to your table and she says, what do you want to drink? And you say, Coke or Pepsi. You don't care which one. You just want something cold to drink. How this works is the computer searches on the term remote sensing for you. The computer also does a search on the term spatial analysis. And when you used AND, you just got that little slice in the middle. But because you're using OR, you get spatial analysis as well as remote sensing, which is a pretty big piece, you can see, because either of those terms are going to be present. That's the OR. So there's a lot there. Sometimes it can be too much, which leads us to our third and final Boolean operator, NOT. So what actually happens is, believe it or not, that's a laptop. I'm just bad at drawing laptops. Is say you do a search on spatial analysis or remote sensing, the two terms, and you get over 5,000 search results. And what are you going to do? How are you going to feel when you get these search results? You're going to look like this. Why is that? Because this isn't Google, and you understand that these academics databases, they're not Google. When you do a search in Google and you get 5,000 search results, that's fantastic. It means that you're able to look at everything that's out there because Google casts the net really far and really wide. But these academic search engine databases, they are targeted specific searches. You are not going to look through all 5,700 whatever search results, but you should be looking through all the search results that you get because you should be targeting your search results really, really carefully. So how do you target things really, really carefully? Well, you did your search on spatial analysis and remote sensing, and you take a look at your 5,000 whatever results, and you notice that a lot of them have to do with the Colorado River. That's cool if you're doing research out in Colorado, but you're in Maryland. So what you do instead is you use the NOT Boolean operator. What you do is you would do a search on remote sensing. You would do a search on remote sensing or spatial analysis. You would do a search on remote sensing or spatial analysis, not Colorado River. And what that will do is it will give you, just like before, all the content that has to do with spatial analysis as well as remote sensing, but that NOT Boolean operator, it erases the stuff that has to do with the Colorado River. It takes it out so that you don't have to look at it and you don't have to wade through it. So instead of 5,700 search results, there's another beautiful laptop, you get something along the lines of 53, which you can look through all of those to be sure that you've got a really clear idea of what research is going on in the topic. Remote sensing or spatial analysis, not Colorado River. And then how do you look? Well, hopefully, you're going to look something like this.